Hello all, and welcome to my first show of my Minecraft project, Ijeria. I've been told a couple of times by now that I should probably start showing a bit of my work, so here goes. Ijeria is a Minecraft project that I began back when Quartzstone first came out. I think it was update 1.51 or something like that. And I started wanting to build temples, old classic era temples. It started on a desert map, random generated map, I think. And I started building them, and then they grew and they grew, and ultimately I started building entire cities. But I was never quite satisfied, so I kept evolving them. And over several iterations, we came to some of what you see here in front of you, which is the current iteration of Ijeria. Some of you already know the history of it, since you might have seen my Facebook updates and albums, where I've been throwing out tons of pictures. Otherwise, a very quick summary is that Ijeria is basically a classical city of life. It has a few fantastical elements in the sense of its grandness, but otherwise I've gone in a much more realistic direction, which is what I've also been trying to accomplish through these different iterations. This is currently the fourth one. The other ones have all had pretty epic builds, in the sense of builds that are way too large for life. The biggest build in here currently is the lighthouse that you see behind us right here, or rather in front of us. Heavily inspired by the lighthouse of Alexandria. You'll also notice the Ankh of life, the Egyptian symbol of life, which is kind of a theme for the entire city. Those observant of you and who know a bit about resource packs will also see that I'm using the Conquest resource pack. Link in the description to where you can get it yourself. I can highly recommend it. It's awesome. Anyway, I'm just gonna quickly stroll over the city here, fly over and show you a bit of it, and then I'll go back to explaining a bit about it later. But first of all, the history of Ijeria started out by, as I said, me building in a desert. Then I started building bigger and bigger temples, and ultimately they simply became too big. I wasn't very good at detailing at a very small space, so each building was huge in order to afford the detail that I wanted. Later on I became better, I learned more techniques on how to implement a lot of detail in a very small area, and also to not be too upset with my, or not upset, but too set in my ways of symmetry. I am a sucker for symmetry. And it's been one of the things that I've been really struggling with in my playstyle. Although, of course, classical cities and all that, you have some symmetrical elements, which helps me because it looks natural in classical buildings. More so than in medieval builds, for example. So, anyway, as you can see, it's still a work in progress. There's a lot that needs to be done. But I definitely think that this is the iteration that will stay. I don't think I'm going to abandon this build like I've abandoned the other ones. So I'll just quickly go through what we have and what my plans are for the place. So, let's start at the beginning. The first build that was constructed was the Temple Hill. You'll notice that it is on a hill and there's only one access. The temple is, of course, the Temple of Life. It will just go here. Templum Vitae up there. You'll also notice the Ankh of Life. And again. it is actually built in this in the same architectural style as real Greek temples, with the number of columns and where the walls are. I think it was called the Pseudodictyral or something like that. But anyway, that is a temple, Temple Hill. On the side here, you have a lot of gardens where people can walk and reflect and meditate. Down here, you have the living rooms for the priests. You have the tombs in here, or the mausoleum. Up here, you have a small shrine, and you have the administrative area where records of people are kept. As we come down Temple Hill, we approach this large plaza where sermons can be kept. People can speak here and offer praise to the gods. Then we have some. Well, we have a small plaza here with an obelisk or obelisk-like thing. I haven't exactly decorated this villa yet, but this is one of the larger mansions for a very rich noble family. And over here we have the library, Biblioteca, which is also inspired slightly by the Library of Alexandria. So we have tons of scrolls in here, and of course in here as well. It's kept pretty simple. I mean, it's not many, many floors. It's just two floors in the central room. But again, this amount of knowledge was huge back in the time that we're talking. So it is actually a pretty impressive library. It also has a small extra building over here with more scrolls. Then we have a lot of small villas and housing up here, which are pretty rich. Quarters, all of it, since it's near the temple and library. As we come down here, we come to the apartment buildings. The first one is over here. We have another one here. In here, we have a small marketplace, actually inspired by The Witcher 3, the Blood and Wine expansion, where there is such a small marketplace that I really liked, and I wanted to kind of implement that one. Then we have lots of single and single housing and large insulae, as they were called back in the Roman times. Big apartment buildings. We also have several stores in the bottom floors here. Let me see if I can find one. Which was also quite usual for Roman and classical builds, especially Roman builds. Back in the Roman times, the bottom floor was for stores, and the top floors were for living. And of course, we have an Arc de Triomphe, or a triumph arc, with a pretty neat statue, which I found a recipe for on YouTube somewhere, and I really liked it. In general, statues are hell to make in Minecraft, so I'm really happy about that one. And I really like this entryway into this part of the city. I think it looks awesome. Here we have the Collegium or University. Pretty significant hall. I think actually we get the glare effect. Yeah, I think that looks absolutely amazing. Anyway, this is a university for so we have lots of learning here. We have some classrooms, and here we have a library. And then, of course, a huge garden with a small shrine, a pond, and actually also an animal cage and so on. So it's actually pretty neat, I think. I was really happy with this build, especially because of all the decorations. And of course, a hall of debate. where the different scholars could come and debate, and students could learn how to debate, since rhetorics was a very, very important part of the classical era. And learning in general was, I mean, philosophy and learning was kind of one of the main staples. Here we have a very large marketplace. Oh, very large and very large. It's a pretty big marketplace in front of the theater, the amphitheater, with a small stage, actually several layers of stage here, so there's plenty of opportunity for staging stuff. We also have a bathhouse over here, where you can kind of go in, arrive in this entry room, you go through here to undress, and then you go into the bathhouse itself, where you have small baths where people can stay, and you have larger baths, the larger pool here, and you also have small relaxation rooms, and also in here, and this could kind of be a steam bath thingy with the cauldron. So basically all of this around here and out to these walls here is gonna be a lot of housing. I'm thinking of building a granary somewhere in here as well to store food. But otherwise, I think I've kind of got most of what should be in this part of town. You will notice these walls here are... they are out towards the sea, and they are basically here to protect against the sea in case storms come. So here we also have the sewer exits. Since this is a... Oh, hi Octopus. Since this is a Romans classical city, the Romans had pretty advanced sewage systems. You'll also notice that it is tiered here. You have two sets of walls, which I really like. I think it creates an awesome effect on the town at large, or on the city at large. And that means that this down here will probably be workshops and a bit poorer housing, where this up here will be the more stone and so on. This will be a bit richer area. But this down here will be a small, a bit poorer area with some workshops, mainly workshops, since the city does need its industry. We of course have the lighthouse, as mentioned before. This is a island nation, so, or island city state, so it will need a pretty gigantic lighthouse just to be epic. I've been, as I said, very inspired by the lighthouse of Alexandria as it is depicted on Google search, Google image search. And I think it's been pretty much a success. When I built it, I kind of figured that the walls made it kind of a stand-in as a tower, as as a fort as well, so that's why there's a lot of arrows, and inside we have weapon storage, and lots of storage in general, because this is kind of a fort if need be. I haven't exactly built a gate yet, but imagine there's a gate in front of the entry, and then you basically have a pretty well-defended fort with several small towers and so on. And of course we have a harbor, including a small wharf here, or shipyard, that's what it's called. And this is the company that builds the ships, they are down here, and then on the upper floor we have a restaurant, or a taverna, I think they're called. And then of course lots of storage and markets down here on the harbor area. Most of these are warehouses for storing goods. Here we have the harbor master's room, where you come and declare your goods and so on, which is right next to the main pier. with a trade ship currently docked, which I am pretty happy about since it's the first time I've built a ship. And I think I was pretty successful in creating the kind of elongated trade ship look that that the Romans and the that were present in the ancient times and the classical era. So yeah, small fish market, because this is a harbor. And up here another taverna. Some housing with some storage and some stores on the bottom floor. I really like this idea of you going in and you kind of have the person's private quarters in there, and then you have the store in here, which hasn't exactly been decorated yet. I haven't decorated every house. I have decorated some of them, but not all of them. Down here we have the royal pier, where the royal ship could put itself at rest, and then there's a separate staircase going all the way up to, I'm just gonna make it light again, to Palace Hill. This up here is where the palace is going to be, with gardens and everything that's going to be there. So I'm probably going to be looking for inspiration from Roman and Greek palace structures. Greece didn't have that many palace structures, at least not very advanced ones, as far as I recall. I may very well be wrong. Oh, that's a starter chest. Anyway, but Rome certainly did have palaces. So I'm looking forward to that build, but I'm kind of I'm saving it for a bit. Until I've constructed a bit more of the city, because I kind of want to enjoy this one. So that's going to be a while before I'm going to build that. Of course, we also have an aqueduct taking water from the mountains down to a reservoir. From this reservoir, it would be distributed to the entire town or city. You will notice that it is higher than most of the city. So from there you have a network of pipes going underneath the entire city. Of course I haven't built that, but you can imagine it. So yeah, I think that's almost it. Of course over here on the other side we have the countryside, where we have a small village, some fields. I'm gonna build a lot more fields and also small dock, smaller piers, as you see here, where people can fish from and so on. Of course, there's a mill. There's gonna be probably a lot more windmills as well, to ground the grain into flour. We also have a quarry over here, since the city requires quite a lot of stone, so we have some quarries here. And there is a very good wooden path leading from the quarry to the city. And I haven't finished the last part of this yet. So yeah, that's basically a quick overview of Ijeria as it is now. So over here we have a countryside with fields. Over here we will probably have some more cities and housing. Up here will be the palace. Down here we have the harbor, which is almost done. We just need the last parts of this up here, which I don't exactly know what to do with. I'm not sure I want to keep that big stair that we have in the middle or in the corner. I'll probably build a lot more fishing, small fishing piers down here, where people can have their fishing boats on this strip of land here, as well as lots of workshops and I wouldn't say poor housing, because slum isn't really a thing in this city, I think. I think it's too rich for that. But still, poorer housing, so not so well kept and maintained. And yeah. Anyway, oh yeah, one last thing. I am thinking of this just to top it all off, but I'm not exactly sure where to go with it yet. I might. Let's see if we can find it. Oh yeah, there it is. I might build a statue out here to kind of build to kind of welcome people to Ijeria, since this is right before the entrance to this bay of Ijeria. And I might expand the harbor at some later date, but for now I think I'll focus on this over here rather than expanding towards here. But yeah, the map here is custom made. I made it in oh, it's not world, it's something else. I can't really recall it right now, but I'll put the name in the description for anyone who's interested. It's a pretty neat little tool where you can form your own worlds. Yeah, so that's how I got this nice little island nation. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I hope that I'll be able to put up a new YouTube video at some point with more to show. Thanks, and take care.